How to receive from the universe that which is already here. This was my dog Bubba. He was still alive when we lived at a rented old beach house in 1999. We walked the beach through searing heat and freezing cold. He was my constant companion for 17 years. I did this painting of him. I cut a piece of his hair off, put it in a tiny baggie, and pinned it to the back of the canvas. I utilized that time to start my day off on a spiritual note, to breathe in deep the scent of the sea, to talk to my higher power, to look inside of who I was without being defined as a mother. It was just a journey of the growing kind. I lived like a monk for 3 years there. I felt sewed into the universe. I pictured Jesus walking beside me. It was a time in my life where I was an empty nester already for about 5 years. I knew something about how the universe worked and how we are all part of it. One big web, all connected to the electromagnetic spectrum we cannot see with our eyes. We can feel it in other ways now more than ever. It was time for the elderly woman who owned the house to sell it. I knew that day would be coming, so my mind was set on buying a house by the beach. Even though my ex-husband and I didn't have credit cards or a credit history, we had little money saved. When I told him we are going to buy a house, he said, "We can't buy a house." "There you go, dreaming again." I said, "We will buy a house. Watch." So I laid myself down and placed my thoughts upon the airwaves, which recorded my thoughts and words directly to the source of power. I then envisioned what I wanted. As the pink apricot morning sun washed over my eyes, I said, "Universe, send me my beach house." In the thought, I imagined it was a beach house with the late afternoon sun streaming in through the windows, illuminating the room in cadmium yellow of day to the soft ribbons of red evening hues. I would walk the beach sometimes with my neighbor Mickey. He had a great sense of humor with a touch of an Irish accent which came shining through. He knew I wanted to move and told me to get a TRW done to see if I qualified. So I had a friend who was a real estate agent. I asked her to do one for me. She also found this house I was renting now. We were the only house that had to evacuate when we had a high tide full moon hurricane, namely Floyd. My neighbor Pat across the street was looking on with concern. Sadly, Pat lost her 15-year-old daughter and her husband. The strange thing is that we now live across the street from each other again in a mirror position as we did all those years ago. One day, outside my house, I saw an old car I didn't recognize. It had a little girl's school bag in it with all her supplies. School just started, so I looked in the car and found an address. I went by the house. It was an old beat-up house. I dropped the bag off on the porch and wrote a note as to where the car was. I went back the next day and left a $20 bill in the mailbox. I didn't tell anyone, never did. Many a wise man have said, when you give to others in an unselfish way, you will also receive. It is one of the laws of reciprocity. Be careful with that one, because there is another saying, no good deed goes unpunished. To get back to the getting what you already have from the universe, but don't know how to tap into it, I talked my ex-husband into changing his thinking that he will never have a good truck. and he wouldn't be able to buy a house. So while we were driving, I told him to pick out the truck he wanted when he saw it. And he looked around and then he saw it. I told him to say, "Universe, I am going to have that." So he said, "Universe, I want that truck there." I said, "No, you have to say you are going to have it. If you say you want it, then you are not really believing you will get it. You want a lot of things." So he said it reluctantly, "Universe, I'm going to have that truck right there." Then we quit smoking, so that was $280 a month between us. That was when cigarettes were only $5 a pack. Once he realized that was a car payment, we picked a date and we quit. Then the universe took over. He got a roofing job for a large car dealership. He took some pay and got the very truck he thought on. I said, "See how it works?" He was so amazed. It was time for the credit check. Like I said, I knew back then that credit cards were a trap, so I held out as long as possible. Our credit report came back with me having a 750 credit rating. His was too low because he had no credit history and everything was in my name. How did I have such a high rating? I didn't realize that Fingerhut was tracking my payments, which were always on time because the interest rate was too high. So I went to the bank and was approved for a house, even though at the time I didn't have a job, but he did. So between the two, we were now able to buy a house. The problem was, how was I going to find a house without a car and also without a real estate? And would you believe what he said? "Oh, I never told you. I have a real estate license, but I'm not active in real estate. I do have access to the MLS, the multi-listing system. Only agents can get into." I was sure I was dreaming. He looked for a house for me by the beach, and he even took me there. Talk about synchronicity. I went to the house and called my then husband. He said, "I don't care, do what you want." So I told the landlord, "The bathroom is so small," but the price was $89,999, right? That I would be back the next day with my husband. When we went the next day, there was a for sale sign on a house two doors down with a parking pad and much bigger overall. The price was the same as the other, so I took that house instead. It needed work, and that is a whole other story. I figured since I was getting what I wanted to give back somehow. So I asked God for a job no one else wanted, figuring this would get me more of what I needed from life somehow. I decided I wanted a job in which I could affect lives in a helpful way. No grandiose ego involved. And I got it. A job right around the corner from where I lived. From there, I bought a car and got a better job in the same field, helping people. So, ask knowing you already have it, and you shall receive it. It all starts with a train of thought. I know this sounds easy in our complicated world. What if you don't know what you want? Like those thoughts in the middle of the night that say, "I wish I had this or that." Then in the same thought you are thinking, "You'll never have it. You cannot do that." You have to believe you will get what you want by visualizing it, feeling it, smelling it, tasting it. Put your positive aura out into the airwaves and the positive will flow back. Remember, negative thinking works too. The minute you think you can't or you'll never, you are stopping it from happening. Then you have to put actions towards that goal. How do you find out what you want? It is that which causes you a measurable amount of pain that you felt at one time and you overcame it, or something you enjoyed doing as a child that you gave up on. That's how I started painting again. Obstacles need not be conquered. They need to be bypassed by thought. Old thought processes replaced with new ways of thinking. And this is the house. I used to paint places I wanted to live. So I painted this house with that thought in mind, that this is where and how I want to live. We have a habit of even stopping our free thought process with personal fears. Fears of past mistakes, imagined phobias, dogmas, and even worldly fears. Now with terrorism in the airwaves, remember this is 1999, now with the hurricanes and all of that, we have to counteract it with love and kindness. Help your neighbors and the elderly as much as possible. And just know that I'm thinking of you, praying for all of you, that you get through this with the least amount of damage. Okay, bye.